Hey everyone, Alan at Waldoch, and today I've got a brand new Waldoch camper van behind us, built on a Ford Transit chassis. Let's go check it out. This is a Waldoch RV camper van. It's got everything and all the bells and whistles you can imagine. So we're gonna try and cover as much of it as possible. Hopefully I don't miss anything, because there's a lot on this van. This is perfect for like the van life people. This is what you're looking for. This is ready to go on van life tomorrow, basically. You're built on a Ford Transit chassis. This has the 3.5 liter EcoBoost. Great motor. It's great fuel economy, great towing capacity for all the toys and whatnots. You got side steps down there. You're gonna notice back end here looks a little different because we got bump outs, so that way you can, you know, sleep lengthwise inside. I'll show you that here shortly. Never mind all the crunching and everything else. It's that time of year where everything's melting. But I will show you. You got exterior lighting out there, so you can hang out outside and, you know, have lights on. You got shore power, so you can plug in, so you're not running your batteries out. I'm gonna try and show you on the outside, but up top there is solar panel, there's a max air fan, there's also a vent so you can keep the fumes out and whatnot. There's a secondary heater for the living space, where you want to call it the RV space, as well as your wastewater removal right there. Another step to get in on the cab there. I'm gonna go jump in. Let's go take a look. Going inside the van, it's just beautiful. I mean, could easily live in this thing. All sorts of cubbies and things. So I'm gonna, like I say, try and cover as much of it as possible. Let's close the door so we can cut out some of the road noise. So first things first, never mind, you know, we live in colder climates, so everything's gotta be winterized. So everything's gotta be labeled that it's been winterized. So I had to move those out of the way, but that's there. You want to see that there's a little cubby space there, maybe soap for like your kitchen sink here, more or less. Got a secondary seat, you know, so you want to sit out and enjoy the outdoors, have the door open kind of thing. Nice little deal. And here we'll show that a little better. I'm going to zoom out so you can see it. I don't know if you really saw how that looks. Yeah, it looks real nice. And then we'll close that. And down below is another cubby. Tons of room in there. Of course, we got one over here. Even more storage. This thing is huge. Here, I'll zoom out. You can see it. That's big. I mean, what, this is 11 and a half or 11 foot. You know, you get like three or four of those things long, almost at least three. So we'll close that. And it's nice because they got these push button locks. They're not going to pop open when you're driving down the road. Same deal. This thing is super long, super big. What you'll see above is this black one here. That's actually a refrigerator. It's really cool. And you can set your temperature up there. Neat little thing. Your sink, and this flips open. I'm going to, well, we'll see if we can pop it open without wrecking the tape too much. But yeah, nice little sink, your faucet. This is all your lighting controls over here. You've got USB as well as your standard 120 volt. You can plug in your phone and other devices. Maybe you want to work on your laptop, you know, put some pillows there and have your laptop here, and you plug in your charger. Neat little thing. You've got your solar panel controller, as well as your wastewater, you know, monitor water tank, all that stuff there. And these are dimmable lights in here. You can flip them all on. I'll have to go turn on the power so you guys can see that. And of course the bed, you know, how can you use this as an RV or a van life van if you don't have a bed? So you got a bed, real nice and comfy, super, super comfy, honestly. And you know, I can easily lay on that. Like I say, I'm 5'10". And I can lay lengthwise. I'd say same deal with most other vans. About 6 feet is where things get a little tight, with height as well as, you know, in this case, length. So yeah, so you can easily lay on that. And if, you know, I suppose if you're taller, you could lay kind of diagonally and it would work. You've got a smart TV on a mount there, so you can, you know, bring it out however you want. And you can watch Netflix and Hulu and all that kind of stuff. There's a nice little max air fan to keep you cool in the summer. And you can reverse that so it can bring air in or take air out, which is real cool with the Max Air fans. You'll see LED lighting up there, up top, additional reading lighting. So I suppose you probably wouldn't want to sit on this side, but it is nice to have the outlet over here. There is vents over there on the side. There's also a USB port over there for charging as well. You got another one up top. You got your carbon monoxide. You know, you always got to think about safety. A little bit of storage over here for remotes and things. Guys, on the sound here, we've got vehicles moving around and people are trying to find them. So sometimes somebody will hit the alarm to find out where that vehicle is. Let's look at the bigger cabinets. So in here, you see this large cabinet. You're probably wondering what's inside here. It's a little bit trickier to show you, but this is a full shower. You got a mirror, real nice. And then on the inside there, you got your shower head, some lighting. You got a vent, you know, you don't want to have all that moisture in here. Of course, your soaps and stuff, your control for the shower. You got your toilet paper storage. And you got a toilet, which is awesome, right? I mean, you got to have a toilet, right? Hangers for clothes or towel, you know, you probably won't put a towel there. Sorry, I didn't see what I was doing with the camera. Additional hangers for clothes or whatever, or towels, etc. And then you've got additional storage. So you've got your normal clothes hanger there, but then a secure box, you know, your valuables, whatever you want to keep in there. It's smart to have. Of course, everything else, you got the lockable buttons, so you don't have to worry about it popping open. Let's open this one up down below. So he's got pull-out drawers, which is real nice, and he's got like an anti-stick material on there, or whatever, anti-slick, you know, slide material. So you put shoes in here, they're not gonna like slide around or bang around or that kind of stuff. Same deal down below. Real nice stuff. Of course, like I say, this is built on a Ford Transit chassis, so I'm gonna show you the front cab as well here in a second. This does have a little slide-out table. You pull it out and it mounts right up here. We'll see if I can show you that here in a minute. Here's that table. And it just comes right out of here, just slides right out. And it's got a little hole, goes right on top of there. And you can raise or lower this, so this is perfect for that chair. It's right here. You see the chair there, you take a seat. And I can raise this up and it'd be a perfect little spot, put a laptop here and just hang out here. It's perfect, right? You know, nice little setup. Can't really complain. And of course I could be sitting outside a little bit too if you wanted, you know, it's a real nice deal. And then when you're done, you just pick it up and it slides right back in this little cubby here behind the seat. So I turn on the solar panels. This is all your controllers here. This is for like your water heater and all that good stuff. This has got your solar and your water conditions, you know, how much fresh water and wastewater you got in your tanks. Some neat little things you can see. You know, usage and all that good stuff. Of course, we leave the protective screens on just for the sake of the buyers and stuff like that. And let's turn on some lights. Okay, so that's the water pump. Don't turn on the water pump. There we go. So there's a switch for the rear over the bed. We'll turn those off. And then there's a switch for the front. So we'll turn those off. And then, you've got additional lights. I can be turned on there. Real nice stuff. I think the shower has a light. So let's see. There we go. So that's the shower lights. Beautiful stuff, right? And then we'll turn those off. Pretty amazing, right? All the stuff they can fit inside this van. Wild. And this is, like I say, built on a Ford Transit chassis. This is not an extended chassis. This is just the standard length, but it is the high roof, so do keep that in mind. I'm gonna flip the camera around so you can see how much room there is in here. 5'10", and I do have a hat on that probably adds like a half an inch or whatever, but you can see there's plenty of room in here, lots and lots of room. If it wasn't for the fact it's so wet around here, I'd probably go jump on the bed and you can see, you know, how much space you got in there, but it's so wet I don't want to get anything dirty in here. Let's head to the back so I can show you like all the other neat stuff out there, because there's a ton of stuff in the rear. Opening up the rear, you got a lot of stuff going on here, so let's see how much of my other stuff I can cover. But hey man, you know, if you want to open up the doors, you want to have that typical van life, you know, parking out by the beach, laying on the bed, this is the way to go right here. You got the bed, you got the doors open, you can watch TV while you're hanging out on the ocean. I mean, come on, it's wild stuff. USB charging ports, of course. See the lighting and stuff there, and you can swivel that TV out, so if you want to like maybe cook something out here, which I'll show you that in a second, but you could have the TV going while you're cooking. All right, here's your long storage, so maybe snowboard, skis, you know, a bike that you can, you know, break down, scooters of course, and like I say, it does pull out, so this thing will come all the way out, and you can set it at different lengths. But let's say you want it right there. Pretty sweet stuff. And underneath here is a gas grill. And let's see if I can open it up one-handed. Really, really cool, right? Let's put that away. And then we'll close that up. And of course, that locks, so you don't have to worry about it sliding out. You've got, you know, all your tubes for your fresh water, your waste water, etc. This is your on and off switch for your solar panel. Also shows you, let's see if you can kind of see it, but I'll show you kind of the status on the batteries and everything else. Pretty cool. I'm gonna actually turn that off at this point. And then you've got your fuse panel for everything, an additional sink, so when you're cooking, you can, you know, wash your hands. This is access points for, you know, this is, you know, rear storage and whatnot. And then down there is all the electronics and batteries and whatnot, you know, stored safe away. You've got additional storage, you know, maybe your utensils for the grill or whatever, you know, stuff that you're hauling and whatnot. Speakers in the rear so you can play some tunes. That's running off the cab stereo, which I'm going to show you here in a second. You've got all that there. I think I covered everything. I think we might actually got covered all. I mean, the other big thing too, of course, is obviously you got a fire extinguisher for safety, not just because of the grill, but you never know, you always want to have that there for safety. Let's head up to the cab and I can show you that. Just give you a quick look here. This is RV certified, so you can get RV insurance on this, which is a little tricky for people that have you know, done van life stuff. They've run into the situation where you can't really insure it as an RV because it's not registered as an RV and it's still a van, and then, you know, there's just a lot of layers to it, whereas this is registered with RV industry, so you can register as an RV and you can insure as an RV, and it makes things a lot easier, less complicated. It also makes it real easy for getting a bank loan, so that's really cool. You've got trailer tow hitch, you know, plugins for all that. These Ford Transits can tow quite a bit, depending on the specs, you know. I think it's like 6,000 up to like 12,000 pounds, but again, it depends on the chassis, the motor, a lot of other stuff. Definitely check Ford spec before you quote me on that, and you know, like I said, depends on the Ford Transit that you purchase, or that, you know, that is built off of for your van here. Head up to the cabin here. All right. So these have cloth seats from the factory, real nice and durable, very comfortable. I've always liked Ford seats myself. It's got the new larger display. I believe that's 2023 feature. Real nice. Let's see, I'm gonna go grab the keys. So now I got the key in, and now you can see all the neat features of the Ford Transit for 2023. Now this is one of the things that I've always loved about the Ford Transit. There's tons of storage, and you just don't see it because when you're sitting back, like, you don't see it. It's cool. But you got tons of storage up here. You know, maps or whatever you want to keep up here. iPad, I don't know. Got a USB-C. You got, you know, 12 volt right there. Real cool. Again, tons of storage. Another little pocket for storage there. I see you can put a key there. Your standard four controls. You know, you got your cruise control and your steering controls, which are a must these days. All the other good stuff. You know, I was never really sure about the cup holder here, but I see it all the time. I see people using those all the time. I'm, you know, right-handed, so left hand seems kind of weird to me, but it is a neat little spot. I've used these Ford Transit. I always pull, like, keys there or something, and that's what I like. But neat little thing there. You've got your, you know, handle, all that good stuff. Plenty of storage in the doors. Got cup holders. More USB charger, 12-volt. Plenty big cup holder. I've always been a big fan of this little storage here. There's tons of room in that thing. You know, these floors are nice and easy to clean. They've got, you know, no carpet. It's just that, you know, rubber down there. Real good stuff. easy to drive. You know, this is perfect. You know, you can just grab the shifter there, very comfortable. But of course, the one thing that stands out like a sore thumb is this large screen. This is new, I believe, for 2023. You get a massive screen that has all your controls. This is your heating and air and your stereo and your phone and everything else. So, I mean, pretty cool. Now, granted, this is on AM. Let's see, we're going to flip it to FM and just skip ahead. But yeah, I mean, pretty nice. All touchscreen. You can adjust everything from there. You can adjust your sound, your tone, everything else, compensation for speed, you know. So if you're driving down the road and you want it to, you know, increase volume when you go faster and, you know, decrease volume when you come to a stop so you can hear things better, that's what that's for. Very, very cool stuff. We will turn off the audio if we can. Let's see if novice that doesn't know what he's doing. There, we'll shut that off. You've got your vehicle features. Let's hit that. And this is the first time I've messed with this, folks. So, you know, that should tell you that, you know, one, I am a tech guy, but I've never messed with this new system. So I don't know much. Let's just put it that way, at least with this new setup. I know Ford's driving modes, but what I don't know is this new system. So normal is just your everyday driving. You've got Eco, which is going to basically, you know, set it up so that you burn less fuel. Slippery is set up so that, you know, it will disengage the traction controls and stuff like that so that you can gain traction where you need to, and may have the steering wheel a little more tight. So that, you know, if you turn real fast, it doesn't let you do that kind of thing. And then tow haul will have better shift points and stuff like that, so that it's easier on the transmission and revs the motor higher, so it's easier to shift and or not to shift, but to go up and down hills and things like that. Really cool stuff there. You got the owner's manual in here, which I know some people don't like that, but I think that's kind of neat. It's nice to be able to just come up, you know, pull it up here online or on the screen here. Easy to get to. You can add your phone, of course. You got GPS, real nice big screen, so you can see all that stuff. Easy to work with. We'll get out of that. Do keep in mind, you know, this has got the screen on it, so, or the screen protector, so it's kind of weird seeing that across the screen there. We'll hit features. So you got Apple CarPlay, Android CarPlay, which is cool. And then I think, yeah, you've got additional settings, so you can add your phone, your sync navigation settings. General stuff, connectivity, vehicle hotspot, which is always a cool thing to have, especially for like an RV or, you know, van life van. You want to be able to have Wi-Fi and maybe not use your phone. You can use your vehicle hotspot. That's pretty cool. Yeah, so all sorts of cool stuff. Real nice, this big display. And then it is nice having the you know, heating and air unit on here. You know, you can all control right there, and then go like that. And the system's gonna shut itself off here because I'm on battery, I'm not running. There we go. Enough of that. So there you go. Hopefully I covered everything in this van. There's a lot of stuff going on. It's very, very cool. If you're interested in like a van life van or an RV camper van, we call this a Waldoch RV camper van. If you're interested in something like this, definitely reach out to us. Our info is down in the description down below. Go to our website, waldoch.com. We're building a new website right now, so you won't see the RV camper van on there. You can't build one right now as of posting this, but hopefully very soon we have that up. And then you can build your RV camper van how you want. And our sales team would love to, you know, look at what you're built, or you look at your build and figure out, you know, what would you like, what you don't like, you know, what it would cost, how long it'll take to build, all that good stuff. And we can make it fit your lifestyle and what your goals are with this van. Of course, like I say, this one's built on a Ford Transit chassis, which is a great chassis. I'm a big fan of it. Works real good. Of course, if you don't really know exactly what you're looking for and you just want to say, you know, hey, you know, salesman there, I'd like to build a camper van, but I'm not really sure on everything. Can you kind of walk me through? Our team would love to help you. Like I say, contact information is down below, phone number, email, all that good stuff. And of course, you can go to our website, or contact forms on there. You know, email that way as well. If you got any questions or concerns, you know, post them in the comments down below. If there's anything you like, you don't like about this van, love to hear that kind of stuff. I always try to get on there and respond back. If I don't, somebody else will. Beyond that, y'all have a great day, and don't forget to like and subscribe. I got plenty more videos like this one coming out soon, and yeah, y'all have a great day. I'll see you later.